by this story.
Yeah.
So the real DA at the time, Gil Garcetti, did an interview with the New York Post over the weekend. And he is taking issue with this show, saying that the dialogue was totally made up. And he is right. To a big point, he is right. That they made Marcia Clark the hero in this thing, and because they needed to have some hero. But, you know, look, I like her, but she wasn't the hero in this, and he is now reinforcing that, saying she kind of screwed up.
Right.
She screwed up.
Yeah, and he didn't even want her to be the lead prosecutor.
Did not want her to be the lead prosecutor. Wanted a guy named Bill Hodgman, who is a mucky muck in the DA's office, great DA, but he had heart problems and collapsed in his office. They showed him collapsing in the courtroom. That didn't happen there. It happened up his office. And they put Marcia in there. She was lobbying hard for it. But the interesting thing is, Garcetti was very clear that he told her, Marcia, do not accept black women on this jury, especially black women with kids. They don't like you. This is a mistake. She said, they do like me. I know I can win them over. And Garcetti said he was so sure that they would either have a not guilty verdict or, best case scenario, a hung jury, that he was actually planning for the next trial during this trial, because he knew they would never get a conviction, which I thought was pretty strong.
Wow.
And he has no...
There's clearly bad blood in the aftermath of this.
He said that the women on the jury thought that she was, I don't know how to say it, but thought that she was the B word.
No, they thought she was a bitch.
Yeah, can I say bitch?
No,
that's all I can say.
We reported it. No, you can say bitch. And that's what that was the exact thing that the jury consultant said to Marcia. And bad blood, you know, Garcetti probably lost the election because of it. But, you know, he got a mistrial in the first Menendez case, which didn't help him. Right. But OJ was the big case, and it probably did cost him the election. So I think there is a little bit of bitterness, but he also kind of went on to say he has an awesome life right now. By the way, his son is the mayor of Los Angeles, Eric Garcetti.
Hi, this is Rosemary in Florida. Ultimately, the blame falls on him, though. I mean, he chose her. It sounds like he's just reviewing his career now, and he's trying to place blame on anyone and anything for his failures. He even partially blamed an earthquake because it moved the trial, it caused the trial to be moved to a less affluent area.
Well, look, you're right, and he did partially blame. You see, the thing is...
Wait, the earthquake?
They said the 94 earthquake damaged the Santa Monica courthouse, and it wasn't capable of handling the huge capacity, so that was the main reason they gave for moving it from Santa Monica. But I'm told that Garcetti wanted to micro the case, and it was easier to do downtown than Santa Monica.
Harvey, doesn't this go even deeper than just than picking her for that particular case? Doesn't he have decision making when it comes to hiring DAs in the first place?
Of course he does.
But so she was staffed poorly.
She was an accomplished DA and had done a really effective job as a prosecutor. He just felt that this was beyond her. Bill Hodgman had been in the office much longer than Marcia. And remember,
he had a two person bench to pull from for this case.
No, but Marcia was a star in the office. She was a star in the office. He just didn't think she was up to going against Johnny Cochran, and he was really upset because he felt that she was ignoring the sound advice of these jury consultants who were telling her what she needed, and she just wasn't listening.
And instead of firing her, he just went, "Ah, screw it."
It was really hard. It would have been really hard to fire a woman on that case and replace her with a man under those circumstances. It would have caused him another huge problem. It really would have. Kind of a no-win.
He didn't win.
Unless, yeah.
And he didn't win.
He didn't win.
We're going to take a break.
When we come back, season one.